Welcome back to the land of Black Duck. I'm Michael Dies Horribly Jones, and I am a bionic monster living in a basement in a town, and things are going pretty well for me right now. I have crafted 16 bayonets, which are impressive throwing weapons. I've been rubbing myself with a vibrator, and I have plenty of berries to eat. I'm not sure in what way exactly my character utilizes the vibrator, but I get there seems to be an implication that is, there seems to be some sort of, I believe it is not in a normal way. We'll just put it that way. It's not the way I would be using a vibrator, probably. I'm not sure. I'm not sure. I'm just not sure about anything these days. But what I am sure about is I would like to collect more spikes and make more bayonets. I have collected 20 long strings. And I have a tanto, which is probably going to be an impressive. How far can I throw? I can throw the tanto 24. Not quite as far as a bayonet, but I'm sure it will do more damage. I am full, but I am thirsty, and I'm still tired. It is morning, though, but I'm still a bit tired. I'm going to sleep a little bit. Just a little bit. Oh yes, and I have bionic. For those of you who have not, or who are just tuning in, I have a bionic noise emitter, which occasionally makes strange and funny noises. Well, I imagine it makes strange and funny noises, like various animal noises or funny sound effects. I'm guessing like the clown horn would be a typical one. just imagining, just embarrassing. It's always embarrassing. Whatever it is, it's the most embarrassing noise in any given situation. It never fails to make me just a bit more depressed about my situation. Really, really, do I have to endure this shame? I will gather some more water. I've got a lot of various containers which I have collected throughout my adventures that I like to fill with water to make my life more convenient. I drink water from the local park. What can I say? I've got a park. I live in a house, a basement in a house. Oops, I broke the sign. I wanted to examine the sign because I forget what the sign said. The sign said, danger doggy minefield. that's funny. Before I thought it said like scoop up your dog do or something, but danger, because it's a joke because there's a lot of signs in this game that say danger minefield, but no, this is danger doggy minefield, as in, you know, the kind of mines that dogs leave. I thought it was funny. Anyways, I have future resources that I will utilize in the future to make myself future food and water. I have future supplies, and that takes care of that, so now I can work on crafting more weaponry without worry. What I do is I bash on a car, and then I make myself some spikes from car metal. I have a bunch of bayonets made from spikes from cars. Now, I think it would be, well, actually, I don't know. How hard would it be to make spikes from metal from a car? I guess it depends on the car. I mean, a lot of cars have like sort of a polymer kind of outside that might be kind of oddly brittle. It depends on the car, wouldn't it? If it's just steel, but I mean, a lot of times it's like weird composites. I don't know. But I mean, I guess you could still make spikes out of it. I guess it would work, but It wouldn't be like a normal spike or a normal bayonet. It'd be kind of an improvised spike, but kind of. Who cares? Spike Factory! I'm a bionic monster that likes to make spikes. And I've got bionic claws. I'm like Wolverine who likes to make spikes. What if Wolverine liked to work in a spike factory because he liked... What if Wolverine liked to throw things, particularly bayonets, because apparently they fly really far. And I don't know why that is, it's just how the game works. Looks like Yeah, now that my fabrication is level 2, every single time I make a bayonet, it is successful. Which is pretty freaking cool, I must say. So now I've got a ton of bayonets. It used to take me a lot of work. It used to take a lot of work to make those long strings. But now I'm loaded up with 26 bayonets. 26. Is that enough? No. Let's make some more. I think that's pretty awesome. More spikes, please. Slowly bashing away parts of this these vehicles. It looks like one vehicle crashed into a cop car. Or something. Some sort of emergency vehicle. I have a bunch of bayonets made from an emergency vehicle, which is kind of fun. Kind of awkward. Spike! Yes. Make another spike. More spikes, please. I think I have like 10 more strings, so I can make 10 more bayonets. Bayonets are really simple to make. Improvised knives are simple to make too, but improvised knives are not quite as good for damage or for throwing range as bayonets. Bayonets are just amazing. They're just amazing, amazing things. And they only take 30 seconds to craft. So once you learn how to craft them properly, they are a cinch. You can just pump them out like nuts. The main difficulty is getting your hands on the spikes and the strings. Mostly the strings, actually. 33. I can make 4 more. Dare I make 4 more? Yes, I think I will. Why not? It's... Well, I need that... I could actually need that many. We do run into a lot of zombies. Remember, you're playing a game where you run into lots and lots of zombies. So sure, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to make a crazy amount of ranged weaponry. I'm going to make myself some extra spikes and bayonets. Now the bayonets. Just keep going round and round. Where I stop is where I should stop. Where I stop, I would like to know. Hopefully I know if I'm competent. Alright, so I'm left with 37 bayonets, a tanto, and one extra spike. And if I need it, I can throw my pocket knife. That is a lot of ammunition. Alright, well, I am ready to face the world and throw things. I'm ready to throw things at the world. I'm ready to take whatever the world throws at me, and I'm ready to throw... things at the world. I'm ready to throw whatever I have at the world. But I do not want to go into the basement with the giant spiders. There is a basement full of giant black widows, and even though I got bitten by a black widow once, it didn't poison me. I don't want to play with giant black widows, because I'm worried that the poison will be so bad that it will be like an instant death sentence. I don't know if that's the case. It probably isn't the case. You can probably actually take one dose of poison, but I don't want to play. No. Let's not do that. Soldiers seen headed underground. Rumors abound as eyewitnesses see troops headed towards underground shelter near a local salon. Expert sources suggest that the soldiers may be headed to a possible underground bunker. Well, that's interesting, but very non-specific. I am going out into the wilderness to gather more food. Do I need to do that? Well, what should I do? Gosh, I don't even know what to do anymore. I have lots of throwing weapons. I just want to find targets. I just want to find something to throw my throwing weapons at, actually. So, yeah, let's just explore. That's all there is to do now. Explore and continue to find resources that I can use to continue to cement my victory. A mosquito. Just a normal one? It can spread disease. Yeah, I think it's just a normal one. I think there can be giant mosquitoes, but this is the normal-sized variety. Spinner zombie is 44 squares away. Oh, and the raccoon is ignoring me? That's not wise for the raccoon. The raccoon took only one... Oh, it was a grazing hit. A grazing hit? That's surprising. Am I having trouble throwing? No? Yeah, my throwing isn't really Well, I mean, my locked thumbs. I've got locked thumbs, so minus 2 dexterity when throwing. I would really love to cure these locked thumbs, but other than that, nothing else is really giving me problems with throwing. So yeah, that was just a fluke, because my character is an expert when throwing. Yeah, I'm just surprised, because I usually get head hits, like crazy. But this time, I got a body hit. Okay, so he's 41 squares away. Now he's 33, okay. And I can throw a bayonet, 29 squares. Aha. So is it time now? Not quite. Okay. I'll step. Now it's time. 29 squares. That is crazy. That is crazy distance. I mean, look at that. I'm having to zoom out so far to see my targets. I mean, that's like, I'm firing at like gun ranges. Who can throw that far? I mean, really. I mean, I know I'm like a really, really strong and dexterous bionic monster, but still, that is extremely skilled at this particular thing. But still, that is pretty crazy. It seems pretty ridiculous if you ask me. I'm feeling pretty confident in my ability to survive. I don't feel like survival is much of an issue anymore. Then I might as well pick up these rolling papers. So I've got some meat that I can cook. And there's a squirrel within range. Haha! Bayonet! The squirrel instantly is killed. And is this where it went? Yes. I will take the bayonet. And I butcher the squirrel successfully. My survival is up to 2. I don't know when that happened. Alright, I've got enough meat. I am going to ignore future animals for now until I get a bit hungry. Maybe I should have taken some travel rations with me. No, there's going to be plenty of targets. I'm in a target-rich environment. Yes. There's a Gracken over there. Hello, Gracken. How close are you now? There's a lot of stuff on the ground. Gracken is at 32 range. So enemies are within range about that far? Is that about right? Yeah, that's about right. So yeah, once I see an enemy on the screen, I can just about start opening fire. Once it gets... Yeah, about that. I mean, a little bit. Once it gets a little bit in the edge of the screen, I can start throwing. It's not quite the edge of the screen. And the Gracken is a bizarre humanoid with a calculating stare and fast hands. They're fast. At least very dexterous. Dexterous is the implication. Now, what's this on the ground? There's like a ton of stuff. 4 science ID cards and a whole bunch of other stuff. Anything interesting nearby? Solder. Not really. Well, a remote control cybernetic implant thing. I guess that's kind of interesting. But I don't know how to install it. I would just really screw myself up, but I've got a lot of screwed up stuff in me, so. Mostly I want my bayonets back, and I wouldn't mind getting those science IDs, so. Alright, let's do that. Take me to the Gracken corpse. And we've got an amoebic mold up there. Is it within range now? Yes, it is. A formless form of slime mold the size of a cow. Well, it may be the size of a cow, but it is far too far away to do anything. And it is quite unfortunate for it that it is the size of a cow, because that means it is easy to hit. I could hit the broadside of a cow. Not sure if I should have taken those bandages with me, but, well, I think it's a good idea. The bandages, yeah, if I get injured, I can heal myself up. That is a reasonable thing to take with me. What else have I taken with me? Oh, yeah, that's right, I took the brass knuckles. Because I could throw... How far can you throw brass knuckles? You can actually throw them pretty far. I find that hilarious. Just because the joke I made about... talk about throwing a punch... And you can throw a punch really far. Brass knuckles. That's funny. I'm going to collect brass knuckles. I'm going to collect brass knuckles so I can throw a punch really far. What is that on the ground? Power armor hauling frame? What? How did I not see that in the thing? A power armor hauling frame. A heavy-duty hauling frame designed to interface with power armor. 40 encumbrance, 120 storage. Protection, 90 bash, 90 cut. Layer strapped. Coverage, 100%. What? So strapped means it's, like, strapped onto you. Like an exosuit? What? Price $10,000. I can understand that. Let's read on. This piece of clothing is designed to protect you from harm and it takes a lot of abuse. This gear is part of power armor. When worn with a power armor power armor helmet, it will fully protect you from radiation. It's part of power armor. It's a hauling frame designed to interface with power armor. So if I wear that, I will probably be super heavily encumbered, but it will protect my torso in a big way. And I've got good head protection. It's tempting to put that on. Rottweiler, okay, those guys are far away. This is the level of zoom I want. I want to put that on. Bayonets. A lab coat that I do not care about. A huge stack of bayonets that I stuck into an amoeba. Any other bayonets that I have forgotten? This viewing mode is kind of useful. Alright. Should I don this? I think I should. It's surprising that I can pick it up. How heavy is that sucker? It only weighs 3.6 pounds. It's actually surprisingly light. It just has a lot of volume. But if I wore it, it'd be 40 encumbrance. To what? 40 encumbrance where? I'm curious. Let's wear this. You cannot... Or no, I don't want to wield it. I want to wear it. Sorry. Wait, you cannot unwield your bionic claws. You can only wear power armor components with power armor. So yeah, I need to find power armor before I can put on this frame. And I don't know why it's complaining about my bionic claws. I don't need to take off my bionic claws to do that. Screwdriver set. Might as well. It's good for screwing. If you want to do some screwing, you gotta have a screwdriver set. Here's another one. And some panties that fit. And it says something about this woman. And she must have had a very big panty size. Or maybe this character has a small panty size. I'm not sure. Wait. But it says something about someone. Alright, 3 science ID cards so I can get into 3 different science labs. That will be fun if I can find one. Should I check out the megastore? It has everything. Or the electronics store, or the bank. Lots of money there. A bowling alley, park, radio station, gardening supplies. What do I want to do? Apartment tower. Let's check out the megastore. The megastore has everything. I'm in safe mode. Going down here, yes. Alright, so I'm hauling a power armor hauling frame. And I can't really carry much more than that. Actually, yeah, let's go back home. Let's go back home and drop off this power armor hauling frame. I'm tired of hauling this around. Or maybe I should just make a note of it on the map where I leave it. Nah, it's out in the middle of nowhere here. I want to put it at least somewhere more memorable. Yeah, we'll put it next to the hospital. Oh, hey there, two snakes. Well, since you're here, or no, your icons are snakes, or they kind of look like a snake, but you're actually like a groundhog and a woodchuck. Well, since you're here, I'm gonna throw bayonets at you. Sorry, you got cornered by the hospital, and I like free food. Hooray, groundhog is delicious. Is it winter yet? Is there going to be more winter? No, it's the middle of summer, so is summer going to continue? I don't know. Sorry, groundhog. I don't know why these rodents have been and associated with the weather in our country, in my country, but they have. Also, I'm going to leave thread here, because I don't have a reason to be carrying all this thread. In fact, I might as well leave the screwdriver set as well. Yeah, some of these things I found. These three things. Okay. I'll be back. I'm hungry and thirsty. Well, I could probably take care of water later, but maybe I should cook up this food. What is this? Oh, it's berry bushes. Nice. Nice. Yes. I will eat these berries. They will make me feel happy. No. Doesn't take much food to make me full. Why didn't I take all the straw? Oh, I left them on the ground. Okay. I'll leave the seeds. Maybe the seeds can grow into a new plant or something. But I... Ooh, blueberries! Delicious. Yes, I will harvest the blueberry bush. Yes, I will ignore that, but I will zoom out so that I see it coming, hopefully. Is there any other bushes with berries, though? Sometimes it's going to be hard to tell in the zoomed-out mode. Anything coming near me? Wait, that one looks like it's bearing a fruit. No, that's a boulder! That boulder looks like it's bearing fruit! Trust me, I know. A what now? A what now? A flaming eye? An eyeball the size of an easy chair! Well, that's an easy comparison. That's an interesting image. A colorful image in the mind, covered in rolling blue flames. It floats through the air, spinning slowly, to draw its gaze in every direction, because it's spinning. Okay, I'm not sure if I want to mess with that. I mean, I was talking about how tough I was feeling with these bayonets, but a flaming eye? That's pretty messed up. I gotta say, that's pretty freaking messed up. How far is that flaming eye? I'm gonna keep my eye on the flaming eye. Ooh, that thing looks like it's looking at me. But I guess it's hard for it not to. So, I'm gonna... there's a lot of food here, though, so I'm gonna observe the flaming eye. I almost want a tango with the flaming eye, but... Labs bombed in further invasion proof. Discounting earlier suggestions of a riot drug, most of New England's scientific labs were bombed simultaneously yesterday. No word yet from the military about who the aggressors are. But it's probably China. Right? That's what people are saying. Okay, well, maybe I'm just blaming... Sorry, China. Maybe, I don't know. The flaming eye is ignoring me. However, it is uninjured. And it does seem to be coming this way. But it's ignoring me? The flaming eye is not a hostile opponent? Is that what you're telling me? It's not a hostile entity? A flaming eye. You're telling me a flaming eye is not a hostile entity that I should be worried about. And there's two of them. And now there's two of them. I think... And I'm shuddering. It's making me shudder. Okay, yeah. That's pretty cool. That is pretty cool. I'm glad I'm meeting something that's actually fearsome, because everything's been pretty boring recently. I was thinking that life was going to be boring. No, Tiegon, there are flaming eyes, and they're looking out for you. So you better look out for them. Although, I don't know, maybe I'm taking these flaming eyes a bit too seriously. But they're making me shudder. I don't like it. I don't like it. I don't like it. I'm going away. I'm going this way. I don't like it. I'm walking away. Swimmer zombie to the south. It's probably going to bug me when I get too close. Right? Right? Oh, hey. You're actually close enough right now. Did I turn... Oh, safe mode off. I just turned safe mode off. Well, safe mode on. But I'm going to throw bayonets at this person. And it's probably going to bug me, but I already know about you. So I'll just kill you, and then it'll stop bugging me. Swimmer zombie dies, sort of. Sort of dies again, if you call it that. If you're very generous with the term, then the swimmer zombie dies. Okay. You had a lot of cash. I mean, I guess swimming is kind of a more affluent thing to do. Because we either need to... I mean, to swim, you either need to live on beachfront property or near a pool or a lake or things like that. So it tends to be slightly more affluent, as they say, people that are swimmers. But not always the case. I'm just making a generalization on why, a strange theory on why a swimmer would have a lot of money, but technically in this game, any zombie can have money, it's an equal chance, I'm just saying things, I'm just talking. Alright, come on out, so there's a horde of zombies in there, and I probably made a noise, didn't I? I'm pretty sure I did at some point. Yeah, safe mode off, I'll never move again if I keep safe mode on. If I chuck bayonets, it's going to be difficult for me to get them back, so I'm going to back off until... Well, also, I don't want to fight such a large horde. I want to thin out the herd a bit, and then slowly take them out, bit by bit. It's also safer that way. I guess I can start throwing. Open fire! My throwing has increased to what now? 12! Wow! And now I can throw 30! Every throwing skill level, you get another square of range, it seems. Or at least with the bayonets, you do. Wow. I am just destroying them. I think I have so many bayonets that they're not going to get a chance. Oh yeah, how about this Tonto? How does this do? Slam, 49. Nicely done, Tonto. My good friend. Okay, I just took out a huge horde of zombies. With relative ease, I just sat back and chucked bayonets at them. Impressive. That was fun. That was nice. It's cleared out most of a superstore, a megastore. Wow. And I didn't even get into combat. And I still am sitting here with my bionic claws ready to fight. That was something. That was fun. Or that was a slaughter. Crowbar. Can be clipped or hooked to a belt loop of the appropriate size. So you're saying I could potentially wear it? Well, if you had a belt, but I'm not wearing a belt, so no. But I might as well pick it up. And I'm going to butcher all these zombies, because I like to butcher zombies. That keeps them from getting back up. Even if that zombie was wearing a hey, giant web spider. You look actually more fearsome than you are. Giant web spider, you should stay in a web. I have tangled with a black widow spider. A giant black widow spider. You're no giant black widow spider. I could beat you in melee, and I have bayonets. Did you just not see what I just did to all these zombies? That guy wasn't paying attention. He clearly wasn't paying attention. Cut, cut, cut. Pick up bayonets. Ooh, some cash. I'm happy about cash. Even though I have never found a single shop in this entire game. It's just the fact that they bother keeping track of cash makes me think that at some point there will be a point. I'm not even going to bother with that $85 one, though. Not even going to bother. That's too low. I don't know. I'm not even going to deign to pick that up. Yeah. You're too... this person was too poor. Too poor for me. So I doubt I'm ever even gonna find the shop, but actually, who knows? Yes, I'll stop butchering. What, another one? Or is that the same one? Did I? No, that's a different one. What is with you guys? What, do I look particularly delicious? Hey there, buddy. I'm gonna actually melee you. That was a little bit. They're actually faster than I expected. Cut, cut, cut. Giant web spider. And giant web spiders are actually delicious. A chitin, you say. An adorable little chitin. I think that's how you pronounce it. A chitin, chitin aside. not the adorable part, though. But it just kind of sounds like something else. Wood saw. No thanks. Cut. Dog spotted. Stop butchering. Yeah. He's tracking me. What is it? What is it with you guys right now? Do I have, like, victim written on my face? Because really, I should be rather fearsome if you can imagine. I'm a bionic monster that looks like they called me a dime store Frankenstein, but I still don't like how they called me that. I'd say I'm at least a more expensive. I'm at least a dollar store Frankenstein. I mean, come on, give me some respect. I can't get no respect here. All right, giant web spider. And a delicious giant web spider stomach. That is just a young tree. It has nothing on it. There's a giant rattlesnake down here. I've got a lot of food and not enough liquids. Bayonets. 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 Giant rattlesnake dies. There's no way I'm going to be able to eat all this food before it rots. Right. I'll just leave the bones and the sinew. I guess I'll take the stomach, but really isn't as much of a reason. Hello there, Mr. Zombie. Bayonets. Bayonets. Oops, what did I just try to do there? Ba-bang! Ooh, what am I throwing at now? Am I throwing another zombie? No, I'm not throwing at all. I am not throwing at all. There's nothing to throw at. Alright. You have $1,000. I guess that's enough to pick up. I guess. Butcher the zombie. Get more butchering skill. How's my survival? It's all right. So there's 8 bones there. There's probably some liquid nourishment in the megastore, but let's focus on food right now. I would like to light a fire. Well, actually, my character's not hungry. He's not even hungry. I'm not even hungry yet, because I'm still harvesting apricots. I don't know what's wrong with me. I just can't stop gathering food. I don't really need these strawberry seeds. Shorts. Caffeinated chewing gum. Yeah, stop butchering. Oh, I said, yeah, I meant to say yes. Thank you. Tonto! 58. Nice. And still, we get like 40 from the bayonets, so bayonets aren't much worse. That's a lot of zombies coming out of that store. A whole lot. I'm kind of worried about using my bayonets so close to the store, because I wonder exactly how many. I might actually run myself out of ammo, but I'm taking them out at an astounding rate. And I always have my claws. I think I have enough. I think I have enough bayonets to take out the entire store worth of zombies. Wow. That is awesome. The pure destructive potential I have is just ridiculous. No. I'm not afraid of a dog. I don't even care if the dog comes up and tries to bite me. Let's go ahead and try it, dog. Butchery. Bayonet. Butcher. Stop butchering. Yeah. I'm surprised you didn't stop me earlier. Wow. You really let those zombies get up to me. Fire. Fire. Would you like me to throw some blueberry seeds at you? I'll do it. No, I won't. And also, I think I'm gonna have to leave this chunk of chitin as well, because I'm running low on space. I don't have space for... Yeah, stop butchering. It's not the dog that I wanted to stop for, it's the other thing there. Whatever you are. Yeah, you. Tonto! Alright. And I always have the brass knuckles. It was almost time to see a survivor's note. What's with these pits? With, like, slot? Huh. What's with these pits with, like, slime? Or something. With, like, sly? I'm guessing it's what's with the pits with, like, slime. That's a hint, I guess. Thank you, Mr. Survivor. Well done. Stop butchering? Heck yeah. Bayonets! Okay. I need more... A saxophone? A saxophone! This gear is generally worn as clothing. Is it? And it can protect me from a lot of damage. And it has one charge. I'm not going to bother with that right now. But my vision is pixelated, so... This saxophone looks really cool. Really looks cool. One charge. I wonder what they mean by that. One reed? Because... You'd think you'd be able to play it more than once. A Tech 9. Interesting. Machine pistol. Classic choice for a lot of criminals of various types. But, I mean, other people too. But it does... Tech 9 seems to have a certain criminal association with it for a lot of people. Including me, apparently. Or I should say, it has a criminal association with it for me, I guess. I have seen it depicted by the media in more cases in use by criminals than law enforcement. That's all I'm saying. Not that that is typically the case, just... Well, actually, I think I was starting to say that at the beginning, but no. The media has led me to believe, or it seems to imply... Oh, I'm just gonna shut up now. Shut up and throw your bayonets. All right. Gosh, some people are very strict. There's a lot of zombies in this store. But I'm getting a lot of usage out of these bayonets. And I'm sure I'm getting a lot of throwing skill out of this too. How's my throwing skill? Nearly at 13. Wow. That is some throwing skill. That is a lot. A lot of throwing I am doing. I don't want to throw my bayonets into the store. I want the zombies to come out of the store. It takes a lot of work to clear out a megastore. But, on the other hand, megastores are usually fairly crowded, I guess. So I guess when things went down, however they went down, there was a lot of people in that store. That's all there is to it. Or that's what I'm led to believe. Makes a lot of sense. Don't make me throw a stomach at you. That would be kind of hilarious. Alright, so I'm just taking these zombies out as they advance. Throwing bayonets after bayonet, but now I'm out, so spike! Okay, that did some good damage. Stomach! that didn't work. Wow, he's right up next to me. Oh, I am tired! All this throwing has made me tired. I've only been walking around. I mean, my character is tired from lack of sleep, too, and I'm a little bit wet. But no. Lack of sleep is not what's making me tired here, it's just all the... Yeesh. Okay, this might be an issue. I'm gonna try to run away. Run away! Because actually fighting... I actually took a hit there. Fighting might not be the answer. I could get infected. Although, I do have some medicine to deal with that. Crowbar! 12 damage. Alright. Throw a punch! 5 damage! Zombie dies! The long distance punch. That's hilarious. Oh, that's hilarious. Headshots. Wham! Brass knuckles. Talking about throwing a punch. Or talk about throwing a punch. That's hilarious. Pocket knife. 24. The pocket knife embeds. Okay. Now what do I do? Now what? You're out of ammo. I actually ran myself out of ammo. This is what I was afraid of. Well... There's some rocks over here. And my character is... Wow, that's more zombies than I expected. God dang, there's a lot of zombies in that superstore. Yeah, I guess what I'm going to do is maneuver around and recollect my bayonets. Of course, that's a little bit risky. How's my stamina doing? It's getting better. Okay. Okay, good. I'm warm. I'm very thirsty. But I'm doing okay. I'm in a little bit of pain, but not much. All right. Small risk here. Small risk. Not too bad. Spike, bayonets. Ooh, Glamopolis. Crowbar. Pick, 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 pick. Go for the better targets first, because picking up takes time. So let's go for the better things to pick up. The bayonets. Pick up them bayonets. A sling pack. Simple sling backpack. Oh, I see. Ooh, hello. More zombies coming out. Really? Really? The superstore isn't empty yet? There's more of you bastards in there? That megastore really is having a mega sale on mega zombies. It's a mega zombie mega store mega blowout. Or did you just get back up? And I killed you earlier. I'm not sure, but I think... Yeah, there's just more. There's more of them coming out. They're coming this way. My word. An M119. Interesting. Well, don't have time for that. I collected enough of these for now. What should I do? I'm going to continue to back up. Wow! It's like, what is there, like a zombie factory just pumping them out in there? I mean, I'm starting to think that there's like just, they're like generating like madness. Because it's just, it's hard to imagine that many zombies in a superstore. But it's a big superstore. It's just, it's like, was it jam-packed? Alright, well, hopefully these webs... I'm hoping that the zombies will get caught in the webs from these giant spiders that I dealt with earlier. Oh, a zombie dog is following me. You want to be cute? You want to be cute, zombie dog? Alright, come a little closer, because I don't want to have to go far to collect my weaponry. Yeah, it seemed like the web technique kind of worked. Alright, fine. Go ahead and just start bashing that car. Fine with me. Perfectly fine with me. Alright, we managed to distract most of our opponents, reducing the number of enemies we have to fight. An FNP90. That one's... The FNP90 became famous to me because of the video game GoldenEye. In James Bond GoldenEye, the Nintendo 64 game, the FNP90 was a ridiculous weapon. It was the best weapon in the game. It was like... broken levels of good. Like, it was, I don't know what they were thinking in that game when they made that weapon. You rarely get that weapon, but when you do, it is absolutely ridiculous. It was hard to describe, but it's like, well, yeah, it's not that hard to describe. It's like, the FNP90 is a simple submachine gun with a 50 round clip, which is pretty amazing. But in the first-person shooter GoldenEye, the FNP90 acts a bit more like a minigun, like a chain gun. Like, it fires out ridiculous amounts of bullets, and then in GoldenEye, reloading was just like, just your gun just goes off screen and comes back up. So it's like, it's like the reloading was so fast in that game because, it was early in video gaming. And realistic reloading was not a top priority. We were happy to be shooting anything at anything at all, really. We weren't very picky on what. Ooh, I'm hungry and very thirsty. I probably should munch a little. But in the middle of combat, I don't know. But being hungry is slowing me down a bit, isn't it? No, it's mostly thirst. Okay, so yeah, definitely don't worry about food. Not in the middle of combat. And not if it's not slowing you down. A house coat. That's a coat for wearing inside the house. No. Makes you wish you had a running water to take a shower. Oh, I guess so. Or I don't really know what a house coat is. Is it like a... Oh, it's like a robe. Is that what a house coat is? It's like a robe. Pack of ciggies. Alright. Saying it like that, saying ciggies, it sounds like affectionate. It does make me feel a bit awkward, because yeah, I don't hold any affection towards cigarettes. It's just something that people say. Alright. Die, zombies. Or, I mean, stop. Stop being animated. Lose. Cease to motion. Cease your motioning. Stop all movement. Wow. These bayonets. I'm getting a lot of work out of these bayonets. And there's still more of them. Woodsaw. Is that the same woodsaw? No, it's a different one. Another wristwatch. So I could be like double wristwatch man. Akimbo wristwatches. I can tell time twice as much. Ooh, a gummy vitamin. Yum. I take some vitamins. It helps my immune system. Ah, cause I'm a Flintstone kid. Okay. Wow, that it's a classic thing for me to say, but that advertisement worked, clearly. There's a bit of advertising dollars well spent. That human being is effectively programmed. Though I can't say it's actually led me to make a purchase. Stop butchering? Heck yeah, stop butchering. Hey, buddy. Are we done now? We're not done. Right. There's an entire horde that's still stuck in the webs. Just slowly working their way through a spider web. It's not something I thought about, is a bunch of zombies stuck in giant webs. Not an image that has entered my mind before, so... Yeah, I have to say, kudos to this game for putting an interesting image in my head, to say the least. I'm not gonna take the hammer. I will not. I will not throw hammers. A Mossberg! Yet another gun that I am not going to use. Because these bayonets are just frickin' better. I'm sorry, that's the way I feel. So let's compare. Apricots. I'm just curious. Apricots. 16-3-3 enjoyability. Blueberries. 16-2. Blueberries, I don't know. I actually might enjoy blueberries more than apricots. Really? You're gonna say that? But, yeah, I guess the quench values. I don't know. I don't really argue with that. And definitely strawberries are way more enjoyable. That's like... Yeah, they say tasty, juicy berry. Strawberry. They're blue. Doesn't mean they're sad. Blueberry. The strawberry definitely should have some enjoyability. I don't care. Unless you eat too many. If you eat... Like, if your diet is all berries, then your... Oops. Then your poo is going to be... It's going to be a bit less enjoyable. We'll say that. A wetsuit that fits will keep you rather warm and is good for swimming. However... That's all it's really good for, so. I don't care about that. A halter top that fits, you say? Oh, well, say no more, my friend. Halter top me up. heck yeah, girlfriend. A Glock 19. Glock. It's a very famous pistol. Known for its light weight and incredible amounts of reliability. If I was a person who was going to buy a pistol, that would be probably one of the ones I would buy. Just because it's cheap and reliable and light. It's a simple, but I'm not the type of person that would own a pistol or a handgun as a personal defense weapon because, yeah, I just don't want to take the time to learn how to utilize a firearm properly. And if you don't properly educate yourself on proper firearm use and you own one, then you're more likely to make a mistake with it and hurt yourself or a loved one. So firearms are for some people. I mean, it's like I wouldn't mind playing around with firearms, but I just don't really have the time or the money. I mean, I occasionally watch some YouTube channels where people, fire guns. And it's interesting, especially when people are utilizing interesting types of bullets. Like bullets that are what they call unconventional ammunition. I feel like those videos are kind of interesting. And when they're using like ballistic jelly and all that stuff. Ballistics is an interesting thing. But yeah, it's more work than... I'll leave that to the experts. We'll just put it that way. I'm an expert in video games, not guns, and I am probably going to keep it that way for now. Keep things like this. We'll make a fire quickly so I can cook some meat, I guess. Really, I'm doing this right now? I'm just gonna start a fire. You know what? This meat's probably all gonna go bad. Who cares? This meat's gonna go bad. I've got so many berries, I don't need this meat. I harvested all this meat, but you know what? I don't need it. Stop dropping? Yeah, I don't even have time to drop. You'd think you could drop faster. I'll throw a rock at you. Right, there's another zombie. I'm killing a lot of zombies this episode. A lot of zombie killing. More zombie killing than I have ever done in my entire career of this game. This guy is a severe killer of zombies and other things. In fact, I'm curious to see my kills at the end of this. A small mechanical clock stopped at 10:10. I don't know if that's in reference to something, but if it is, I do not get it. Obviously. If I did get it, I would know if that's a reference. It seems like a reference. It has the feel of a reference, but I don't really know. I like your references, yes. Very good. I see your references check out, and they're very good. Tonto! Attack! Bayonets. I think I actually recovered most of my bayonets. A wood axe is heavy, so I'm not going to take it. It's very good for cutting down trees, though, so if at some point I want to do some tree cutting, wood axe. Is the store actually clear? I know that the spider web isn't. Yeah, there's a bunch of zombies in the spider web, and in fact, I kind of feel like I want to clear out some of these zombies out there in the spider web before I go into the store, just so that when I come out of the store I don't find myself surrounded of some sort, or in some way. But that is, it's a lot more work. There's a lot more work to be done. My throwing skill is 13. I don't know when that happened, because I've just been throwing and throwing and throwing and throwing and throwing. Can I get a zoom out? Thank you. Throw your boat gently down the stream. I don't even know who I'm throwing at now. Oh, no one. All right. Regather my weapons. Ooh, a tailor's kit. Might as well pick that up for now. Even though I've gotten more than one tailor kit before. Oh well, it doesn't matter. Get my bayonets back. Attract some more zombies. Alright, after I kill this set of zombies, I finally think I will feel confident enough to get myself in the store. That is impressive damage. I do really, really impressive damage with these things. And I can throw it 31 spaces and do incredible damage. That is just something. That is very impressive. Just for throwing, because, I mean, the thing that's crazy about it is that I can throw all day. You know, it's like if I was using guns, I would need a lot of ammo. I would have gone through a lot of ammo if I was using guns. But these bayonets, I can just keep throwing them, getting them back and throwing them, and just slowly work my way through an entire store worth of zombies. An entire mega store worth of zombies. And I'm going to butcher these because A, it gives me experience, and B, it prevents zombies from getting back up. And somehow it does make me feel a slight amount of vindication. Take that, zombies. I hate zombies. I'm just gonna really harp on these zombies. Multiple reasons. I get to feel... Okay, it's getting dark. Stop butchering? Heck yeah. I feel a little bit more afraid at night. Because there's more threats of being surrounded. But I'm not done yet. It's a lot of butchering to be done. But I am very thirsty. Maybe I should give it a rest and find something to drink. And then maybe I should finish up. So any of these vending machines... Whoa, okay, these vending machines do have a lot to offer. Like clean water and cranberry juice. Hooray, thank you, vending machines. All right. Cranberries? Cranberry juice, you say? Delicious cranberry juice for you, sir. Thank you. No. Don't you like cranberry juice? Actually, I'm not really a fan of cranberry juice. I find it very tart. And the cranberry industry, they're putting cranberries in everything these days. I mean, it's like I'm surprised. Apple juice? I think that was a comedian's routine. I forget which one. But it's like apple juice? You wouldn't mind putting cranberries in that, would you? Banana juice, you say? Wait, banana juice? Well, pineapple juice? You wouldn't mind adding cranberries to that, would you? Orange juice, you say? Pomegranate, you say? Any juice. They've probably added cranberries to it. There's a certain fruit that is kind of fun to say in a funny way. Like, kumquat. Kumquat is another one. Kumquat! You just also get to say cum. I can shatter the glass more. Congratulations, okay. Any zombies in here? I shattered glass. I'm smashing a counter. Anyone responding to that? Okay, I think I actually, for the most part, have cleared out this superstore. So the question is, do I want to sleep in the superstore, or do I want to walk all the way back to my home and risk meeting something out there? Am I more afraid of what could spawn in here, or more afraid, well, yeah, the superstore... That's the thing. I was thinking, if I want to sleep in here, I better try to secure the superstore. And there might be a lot more zombies in here. Get away, zombie. Right, why am I scrolling through it? I have my bayonets on T. Give me those. Give me that. Clean water. Wonderful. Paper wrapper. Clean water. Yes. Cardboard box. Herbal tea. Nice. Excuse me, can't you see I'm shopping? How rude. What kind of... There's some sort of pervert going around this store. I'm going to contact the store manager. Store manager, protein shake. I'm gonna get myself some muscles. Hell yeah. That's a lot of nutrition. And actually, more quench than cranberry juice? Really? And how much quench does water give? Okay, 50 quench. I was gonna say, water really should be the most quench that you can get. I mean, how can you get more quench than water? But, okay. Alright, fair enough. Everything else, I don't know. Signal flares? I don't know about that. Well, actually, I don't have anything to load it into, so yeah, I'll just leave that for now. Just gonna get some water off football. Well, excuse me. Well, it would be kind of fun to throw footballs at people, but not very effective. Just something that's funny about fighting with a football. But mostly you'd want to disassemble it into a few patches. And hello there, zombie. Did not seem like he saw me properly, which is good. My night vision gives me a big advantage here in the store. Well, not a big advantage, but an advantage. A small advantage, I should say, in here, over the zombies. But my bayonets give me a huge advantage anywhere, which is pretty freaking awesome. Although I have been forgetting to use my Tonto, but not anymore. Tonto away! Well done, Tonto. Yeah, the Tonto does not do much more damage than my my bayonets. At first, I thought those hiking boots were a pewter bowl. A pewter bowl without a lid. I guess I might as well, I guess. More storage containers. Bayonets. 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 Tonto. Don't want to lose that. Some more signal flares. Books. Shotguns. The Art and the Science. Big Book of First Aid. Trapper's Life. Well, yeah, might as well take that, I guess. Some thread. I guess, why not? Bandages, definitely. Maybe I'll leave the thread instead. And I don't need a cotton ball, exactly. Well, just one. When I've got bandages. Bandages, cotton balls are like a poor man's bandage. Don't make me throw gummy vitamins at you! You'll feel better. Feel better, zombie! Gummy vitamins! It turns out that gummy vitamins are the cure to the zombie virus, and the person turned back into a normal human being. And explained that I should feel rather guilty about not curing other human beings, and the fact that every other person I have killed up to this point kind of makes me sort of a murderer, except for that I didn't know that there was a cure. But that I should feel bad. And I'm going to leave these gummy vitamins behind, despite the fact that they are the true and one and only cure to the zombie virus. Zero warmth, airwool elbow pads, and zero encumbrance, you say. I need good armor that has zero warmth, actually, at the moment. I put on my elbow pads. The elbow pads, wait, they go... They cover the arms, right? Is that what they're going to say? Strapped. They say strapped layer. Strapped layer. So, they don't seem to be affecting my arms. My legs are affected by something else, right? What are my legs being affected by? The cargo shorts and the cargo pants. That's right. I probably don't need so much on my legs. And that encumbrance on my legs is affecting me by one movement point. It's fine, actually. I like the extra storage space. The extra storage space gives me more bayonets. It's worth the small amount I'm facing. Zombie survival guide is not very useful, despite the fact that it sounds like it possibly could be. I really think it should have some usefulness, just not much. Like, it should teach you, like, some ridiculous kind of, it should teach you some frivolous recipes. Some, recipes that aren't maybe really suggested, but can be used. That's right, I never use those rollerblades, but I just can't trust rollerblades. I don't know how they work. I never was good at rollerblading. What was that? Oh, just, yeah, talking doll. I don't feel like pulling the battery out of a talking doll. I've got plenty of batteries right now. Oh, that's a bit too close to the zombie. Okay, zombie, I get it. You're angry. We're all angry. Oh, I've been running around. Or no. No, I haven't. Sorry. I thought I was running around. But I started running. That's for sure. Knee-high boots. All right, are we anywhere close to having cleared this store? A scythe that could be made into a war scythe. That could be awfully fun, but earplugs, not as useful. It's not the weapon for me, considering I have bionic claws. And I had found a nodachi earlier. Dance, dance, dance. Learn the trendiest dance moves. You want to be a dancer? Then read dance, dance, dance. It's kind of the Dance Dance Revolution kind of voice. Or no, maybe it's not. I don't know. It is a voice. It's not my normal voice. That's Boxing Monthly. Swimming Trunks. More rollerblades that fits. Every pair of rollerblades I find fits. And yet I still don't wear them. A roller mat. Well, I might as well pick it up and... Yeah, maybe I... This is making me think that maybe I should sleep in the store. Yeah, take that roller mat. Put it down in the corner. Then I'll take this shelf. And I'll put it there. And I'll take this shelf and I'll put it here. And I'll take this shelf. I'll put it like that, and I'll just kind of make a fort. I'll make myself a fort, and I'll sleep in the corner. Hiking boots, you say? Hiking boots. What are my currents? That's right, my current things are sneakers. My current sneakers are great as far as encumbrance to value. It's not the greatest protection, but as far as being low encumbrance and effective, it is definitely working. A hockey mask. That's kind of what I think of, or either that, or like, well, yeah, like the Jason Voorhees kind of. I don't think I want to wear this because even though it provides a good amount of protection, my face has been fairly well protected so far, and also the encumbrance value seems a bit high. Although I'm curious. Let me put that on. Well, maybe not just yet. As soon as the heat dies down. Excuse me, could you give me a moment? I am shopping here. Don't make me whoopsie doodle. Whoopsie doodle. I did not mean to do that. Let me back away. Sorry. Excuse me, sir. Sorry, I didn't mean to dampen your shopping experience. Let's both continue to try to have the best shopping experience we possibly can. I'm sorry, fellow customer. There's this mega store. Well, that's the thing. It's not a superstore. It's a mega store. So no wonder it has mega zombies. It's like a city. This place is like a city unto itself. It's like a small town. This is like a small town of shopping. That's like the tagline for this place. It's like a small town of shopping. Just a small town. A purse. Now I can truly feel like a lady. Because and now I have a place to store my lipstick and all my feminine needs. My feminine hygiene items. You know, like my creams for the yeast infection and the tampons. Yes, I could have just stopped at feminine hygiene, but I had to smell it out. I had to smell it out. Really had to smell it. Get my nose in there and just... Jesus. What's wrong with me? I've been throwing bayonets at zombies so long that I've forgotten proper basic communication. A razor blade! Which I could use to make a shaving kit. Okay. Or maybe something... I was thinking I could make something else with razor blades in it. Maybe. But I just don't have that recipe. Or, I don't know. It's hard to know how many things are in the game and what's not. That you just don't have the recipe for. You do start with a lot of recipes, but there's a lot of other recipes you can learn as well. Holy mackerel, that's a lot of zombies I'm killing. I'm out. I'm actually out of ammo. Tonto, go! Alright. It's a lot of zombies I'm killing. A lot of zombies. I'm almost up to 14 throwing skills. A lot of zombies. I mean, that's a lot of zombies. Did I mention I just killed a lot of zombies? Welcome back, Tonto. Thank you for helping me out as usual. I'm indebted to you. First aid kit, cool. More bayonets. Bayonets. I am tired. Can't I take a break from all the killing? Can't I sleep in your superstore in peace? Well, with how big the superstore is, I probably could have gotten away with sleeping in the corner, but I just don't like the idea of sleeping in the corner of a store that has zombies still in it. Maybe if I fed all the zombies non-drowsy cough syrup. Maybe non-drowsy cough syrup is what has caused this whole problem in the first place. They're not zombies, they're just on non-drowsy cough syrup. They're on the drowsy cough syrup. You should have had the non-drowsy cough syrup. Or maybe it's the other way around, I don't know. One of the two. Lay off the cough syrup. An electric polisher. I'll have to use this on my balls. These four rocks? Well, I guess I'll have to get my rocks off into the ball polisher. Conical ball 22, a variety of ball, of ammunition, 22 ammunition, 22 ball, okay. Yep, yet another type of bullets that I probably won't be using because I rarely use guns. Or this character does not use guns, really. A hot plate. This plate is, a plastic canteen. Its volume is 6. And it can store a liter, but it can be worn around my waist. So that's cool. It's a thing you can wear. Oh, right, it's in the hockey mask. Let us don the hockey mask. Okay, so that brings my eyes and my mouth up to 20, which means that I'm not going to be able to throw throwing items nearly as well. And it will be more difficult to breathe and catch your breath. Okay, so mouth encumbrance now no longer makes it so you move slower. Mouth encumbrance affects your stamina for running. That's kind of cool. So mouth encumbrance isn't nearly so bad, but it's the perception value that I kind of don't like losing. A dive bag. A lightweight mesh backpack commonly used by divers. And it performs well when wet, but I've got enough backpack type items. Carbon fiber arrows. Well, I guess I'm wearing the mask for now. Let me see. If I threw, let's say, like, one of my bayonets, 31, does it affect my range when throwing? Take off the hockey mask. Does perception actually affect your range? 31. No, it doesn't affect your range. Just like maybe your accuracy. Well, if it just affects your accuracy, then maybe I'm changing my tune. Because my accuracy is dang good. Also, oops, I dropped my brass knuckles. Okay, so if I wear the mask, my accuracy will be reduced. The only other problem with wearing this mask I can see is that I might not be able to see a trap, and then I get killed by the trap. So, like minefields. Minefields are a bit of an issue. I heard clang. Stop butchering? Yes. Oh, also, how hot is the mask? Is my face hot? Nope. Okay. Well, I guess I'm gonna wear this hockey mask for now. I mean, it'll definitely keep my face safe. So I'm wearing an army helmet and a hockey mask. My head is safe. I'm probably gonna die from torso or arm wounds. And my arms are feeling safe thanks to the elbow pads a bit more. So it's probably like chest wounds. I'm in the most danger of dying by chest wounds. And the torso is a pretty tough area. So, yeah, I guess I'm feeling all right. It'll take a while. Yes, stop. Yes, yes, yes. Oops. Oh, Tonto away! I said Tonto, not medkit. Or brass knuckles, sorry. Tonto away! Good. Way to go, Tonto. It's surprising how many zombies are still left. And how big this superstore is. This superstore, megastore, sorry, is ginormous. It is just amazingly packed with shelves upon shelves full of zombies and enemies and items and other things. And a radio, which I'm going to turn on for fun. Well, actually, maybe not, because I might attract some zombies my way. When I'm looking for zombies... Ooh, a tent! It provides a large amount of space, but it's very bulky. I might play with that later. I might just play with that later. Swim fins! Fun. If I wanted to be a swimmer and just kind of swim around in the river, I'm safe from zombies as long as I'm swimming in the river. I could put on a wetsuit and diving fins. And, Although, that's right, I remember seeing a zombie shark, so... I do remember seeing a zombie shark in a previous version of this game. So, being a diver and avoiding zombies, being a diver in order to avoid zombies, probably not going to work out. A concrete mixer. Well, that's interesting. If I were to make like a concrete wall to save me, I could do that. Oh, it looks like there's some liquid on the ground. Wow, this is really full of stuff. But it looks like the zombies bashed in some of the liquids, but wow. This liquid for ages. Liquid nourishment for ages. Oh, I thought I was thirsty. Oops. Hello there, zombie. There's always more of you, isn't there? Alright, gotcha. Alright, I'm gonna butcher you, because the zombies have a disturbing tendency to get back up. But I can't finish all the V8s. Why? Why can't I finish all the V8s? Because it's a huge amount of nutrition. Wow, V8 is something. Alright then, I'll just drink cranberry juice. Cranberry, you say? Very good, sir. And that also fed me. So yeah, maybe I should have just been drinking plain old water, because a lot of these juices actually have a lot of nourishment in them. Bayonets. Alright, more of you guys. Guess you're still coming out from the webbing. Alright, butcher you. Alright, now can I get some sleep? My god, am I tired. Apricot. What I'm going to set here is some of my extra food. Oh, no, drop to location. Drop where? Over there on the shelf. I'm going to use the shelf and put all my stuff on the shelf. Because this is some top shelf stuff right here. You know what I'm saying? Real top shelf. Alright, yeah, all my food, the bandages, the first aid kits, this radio. I'll keep my weaponry for now, put the trapper's life over there. These bottles. Alright, put that all up there, and I'll be back in a moment. Making boots, foot crank. Oh, for a bicycle. Interesting. The store didn't really... I mean, I guess they're kind of in sections. Kind of. But what kind of section has, like, a pot, a t-shirt, and a foot crank next to hiking boots? It's like the sections of the store are kind of confused. Kind of confused sections in the stores. Whoever organized the store probably got was probably going to get fired if the apocalypse hadn't come around. So wait, out of curiosity, if I dropped all my cash cards at the same time... Would that give me volume? No. Okay, then cancel. I'm just curious. I was curious if they added up, because if they all added up like that, I wouldn't want to deal with it. Boxing gloves that fit. let's see. It can protect you. It provides a lot of protection, but 60 encumbrance. And then you can go, you know what I'd like to do? I'd like to put those on and then go use a computer. And then it'd ask me the question, how can you type with boxing gloves on your hands? Actually, I wonder if the game would a tragedy novel or a horror novel. Not really a fan of tragedy. You get enough of it in life. Who needs to read about that? Plastic bottle of none, drowsy cough syrup. All right, where's that tent? What was this? Sci-fi novel. No, thank you. That's too advanced. Those sci-fi novels. Those sci-fi people, they are geniuses. I don't know how they do it. I don't know. All that stuff is just way over my head. Bike helmet is nice, but it's no army helmet. It's no army helmet. Now, where did I see that tent? Somewhere up here. Keep butchering zombies, because otherwise they'll get back up to haunt me. Or, well, more than haunt me. I wish they only haunted me. I wish that's all they did. I don't want to butcher computer gaming. No! There's the tent. Butchering computer gaming, that's like sacrilege to me. That's my religious text. A computer gaming book. I wouldn't be able to do much computer gaming in the aftermath. Well, the handheld systems. Right. A sports bra that fits, all right. Well, now that's comfort. Gotta keep my... Where? Wow. Okay. Oh, you guys are coming from the outside. Okay. Wow. That makes me think of that old... Yeah, sure. Yep. They're coming back in. We want back in. We got tired of the web. We want back in our store. We want to shop more. Wow, there's a lot of you out here. Whoops, got a little bit too close. Oh, there's more noise coming from... Yeesh. It's starting to make me think that, yes, they are spawning in large number. Did you have some additional bayonets that I threw at you earlier, or... No, I just maybe threw... Or did you just take a lot or something? I don't know. Oh, a pair of brass knuckles. I think you just gave me those, right? Or no, I accidentally threw them. Oops. Butcher. Okay. Butcher. And here's a sundress. And yeah, as I say, that looks like a flashlight. And yes, it is. But I can't butcher that one. Huh. I was going to say, am I just hearing things? No, you are not. Oh, and these rocks are a bit outdated. Get rid of that. Thud. Thought I heard something up here. No? Okay. Well, when will I be able to get some rest? I'm starting to think that a superstore or a megastore is not the best place to get some rest. Zombies really like destroying cars, don't they? I don't know why, but I feel like they really enjoy it. It's like a pastime. I like standing around brains, walks in the park, and bashing cars and windows. I like bashing things and brains. I don't know. It's like a dating video for zombies. The usual likes are bashing things, brains. I don't know. Other stuff. Stop, bash, or stop, yes. Oh, from behind. Hello there. I am killing a massive number of zombies, although some of them could have come back to life. I'm butchering as many as I can. I'm trying to prevent them from getting back up. But they still seem to keep coming. Bayonet, bayonet, bayonet. It's like... I was fighting all day and I'm fighting all night. Alright, can I stop now? Are we hearing things? Butcher you, butcher you. I think it's over. Wait, where did I put that tent? I still have my tent. Okay, activate tent. Alright, no, can I activate here? Yeah. Where's that too? Not enough space. Okay, we need more space. Alright, is that enough space? Activate tent. It is a large tent, isn't it? Okay. Well, I would like to have some shelves. Can I unveil a tent in a superstore? I've seen people put out tents in stores. It's usually how they display them. They usually have a display tent. So, hello zombies, would you like to check out my tent display? There's stuff in the way. Okay, sorry. Oh, wow, it's daytime. Okay. I'm still trying to get to sleep. It's gonna be harder to sleep in the middle of the day. Alright, is that enough room? Or am I gonna have to move those objects? Alright, let's move these objects just in case. Alrighty. And this too, this composite bow. And it's a bit hot in here. I'm gonna knock my socks off. Alrighty. Composite bow. There we go. Pick up all this nonsense. Drop it way up here. I have a lot of berries. And just to make sure that there's no other variables, I'm even gonna pack up that. Now can I deploy? Nope. Okay. I just thought that those, I wasn't sure if those were variables or not. So can I deploy a large tent in a store? And exactly how is it thinking about the deployments? Like, just outwards, like, a... Okay, there we go. There's the tent. Examine the center square to pack it up again. Yes, I would like to take it down, because I would like it's like one square over and one square down. Can we get that? Yeah, now that's a tent in a store. All right. I now have a tent in a store. Is that ridiculous? I don't know, but I'm doing it. And now in that corner, we're going to put a roll mat. All right, now I'm starting to live in a fort. This is an interesting. Am I going to live here now? I don't know. Because, I mean, I had a nice... Well, this will be like my second home, my home away from home. I've got the mega store house, and then I've got my other house. That's all. You just have you have multiple campsites. That's all. If my first campsite gets overrun, then I can come to this one. If this one gets overrun, then I go to the other one. That's all. And I'm staying here for tonight. You don't necessarily have to choose one over the other. In fact, a smart survivalist. It's annoying that objects on the ground are difficult to move. I have to pick them up and put them down like that. Alright. Good enough. Alright, give me my food back. Delicious food. Munch down on the blueberries. Drink some water. Blueberry, blueberry, blueberry. Water. Nope, okay. Let's go to bed. First, I gotta shut the door. Anyways, to do that, there we go. All right. Actually, I probably should pull a shelf right in front of my tent. There we go. I feel safe about that. All right. Good night. My vision's all pixelated. That's pretty cool. And I'm making noise. Honk. Oh, something heard the noise and is whacking on the edge of the store. Okay, so that will be an issue from time to time. I wonder if they'll ever break through the wall of the store, because, I mean, they can whack on the store all they want, but it's got to be pretty powerful to break through the wall. But I could have a rude awakening or something really powerful. I'm imagining if there's, like, something really powerful in the game that can just break through walls. I don't know what... But, like, well, I remember there was, like, a little tank. Imagine a tank comes just grinding through the wall, hunting me down because I made a weird noise. That could be a bit awkward. So that's like the one problem with that setup is I'm at the corner of the store and I'm making noise so that something outside the corner of the store will hear it and potentially hurt Clang. Stop butchering? Yeah, and that's from inside. Yeah, I get the feeling that this mega store just is a mega zombie spawner. It's fun, but you'd get no peace. You can't get any peace. It's either that or just, I killed a lot of zombies, but I didn't butcher them all, so maybe... Could it be that all these zombies are getting back up? No. Some of these bastards have to be spawning. They have to be. Right? I'm up to 14 throwing skill now. They almost have to be. It sure seems like it. Sure seems like they're spawning something fierce. Let's get one or two more shelves in this direction. Alright, fine. Make some more noise outside. See if I care. I do care, actually. I'm gonna come kill you. Alright, just a moment. I'm coming. Right, we need to butcher these guys. Butcher. I thought I heard something out here. Nothing? Hello? Zombies? A massive pile of bones. It looks like a graveyard. Alright, blueberry. Huh. Alright then, I'm going to bed. Go through my little labyrinth here. Pull the door shut. And I'll just sleep. Something is making noise, that's me. Hmm. Maybe it was just... I mean, I did kill a massive number of zombies. Maybe all those zombies I were hearing... Nope, maybe not. Something else is making noise. I was gonna say, maybe all those other zombies I were hearing were, in fact, spawned... Or not spawned, but getting back up from the zombies I killed. But no, because now I sleep, and the store is once again full of zombies. Okay, I slashed that one. Yeah, I slashed that one to death. I was taking a few risks, but I've got medical supplies, so. Yeah, this is not the place to sleep. But I've had enough for now, so I'm actually going to save the game here. Thank you very much for watching this up. Oh, one thing, I'm curious, though. How many enemies? How many enemies have I killed now? There was a way to get that information, right? Not safe mode on, but I guess safe mode. Having safe mode on will make me. It'll give me pause when I come back. It will remind me that I'm in a bad situation. So if I'm disoriented when I play this again, it will reorient me in some little way. But kills list. Oh, it's a parenthesis. We killed 4Z9, 1 black rat. How many zombies now? 198 zombies. That is a lot of zombies. That's a small community of zombies. Not a particular ton of anything else, except for spitters. 25 spitters and 39 boomers. Other than that, nothing too special, but I do feel good about that one zombie brute. Apparently, my crowning achievement, the most powerful opponent I've killed, obviously, is a zombie brute. But I've killed a lot of zombies. So, thank you for joining me today. I hope you enjoyed it, and like and subscribe if you did. Good night, and keep surviving out there, survivors.